Namaste, welcome to the online class. In today's class, let us discuss the applications of De Morgan's theorem. First application, De Morgan's theorems are useful in the implementation of basic gates and or not gates. They are called as basic gates with alternative gates. We can derive and or not gates using NAND gate and NOR gate. You will study this in the next chapter, that is in logic gates chapter. Second application, they are used in the simplification of Boolean expression. Boolean expressions can be simplified using De Morgan's theorems. Third application, they are commonly applied to text searching using AND or NOT operator. In the document, if you are going to search text, for example, you want to search two texts, say bus and car, we will use bus and car. So here we use AND operator. In this case also, De Morgan's theorems are used. Fourth application, they are used in the general concept of mathematical duality. In mathematics, De Morgan's theorems are used. So these are the four applications of De Morgan's theorem. First application, useful in the implementation of basic gates. We can derive AND or NOT gates using alternative gates. They are NAND, NOR gates. They are used in the simplification of Boolean expression. They are commonly applied to text searching in the document using AND or NOT operators. And the last application is used in the general concept of mathematical duality. Okay, dear students, in the last class we have discussed the first De Morgan's theorem, that is x plus y whole bar is equal to x bar into y bar. This De Morgan's second theorem, that is x into y whole bar is equal to x bar plus y bar, that is complement of the product is equal to sum of their individual complements. Complement of the product is equal to sum of their individual complement. In the last class we have discussed De Morgan's first theorem, that is x plus y whole bar is equal to x bar into y bar, that is complement of the sum is equal to product of their individual complements. Okay, let us draw the logic circuit for the De Morgan's second theorem. X and Y. X, Y are the two input signals. Perform AND operation between them. So here we get X and Y. Then to find out complement of X and Y, add NOT gate. Then we get X and Y whole bar. That is equal to X bar plus Y bar. X input signal. To find out x bar, we need to add NOT gate. Here we get x bar, another input signal y, add NOT gate to get y bar. Next, perform OR between them. OR operation between x bar and y bar, so that we get x bar plus y bar. This is the logic circuit of De Morgan's second theorem. Complement of the product is equal to sum of their individual complements. Let us prove De Morgan's second theorem using truth table method. So in the expression there are two variables, x variable and y variable. Variable x, variable y, x and y, x and y, x and y bar, x and y bar, then x bar, y bar, x bar plus y bar, x bar plus y bar. After solving this, fourth column must be identical to seventh column. There are two variables, so four combinations of zeros and ones. Two zeros, two ones. Next, in the second column, 0, 1, 0, 1. Next, perform AND between X and Y. 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. Next, complement of X and Y. Now, values of X and Y are 0, 0, 0, 1. Now, we have to find out complement. 0, complement of 0 is 1. 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. Next, find out X bar. Value of X is 0, X bar is 1. X is 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0. Y bar, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. And last column, X bar plus Y bar. Means we have to perform OR operation between 5th column and 6th column. X bar or Y bar. We know the rule of OR operation. In OR operation, if any one of the input signal is 1 or if both the input signals are 1, then output is 1. 1, 0. First input signal is 1. Output is 1. Next, 1, 0. 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0. Now, according to De Morgan's second theorem, 4th column and 7th column are having the same values. 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0. Hence, the theorem is proved using truth table method. Let us prove the theorem using algebraic method. Algebraic method. To prove De Morgan's theorem using algebraic method, we will use complementary laws. So, complementary laws states that A plus A bar is equal to 1, A into A bar is equal to 0. So, here we will use complementary laws. That is A plus A bar is equal to 1 and A into A bar is equal to 0. Second De Morgan theorem is X into Y whole bar is equal to X bar plus Y bar. Now, if X bar plus Y bar is the complement of X plus Y, the complement of X and Y is X bar plus Y bar, if complement of X and Y is X bar plus Y bar, then we can assume X and Y as A, X bar plus Y bar as A bar. If RHS is the complement of LHS, then we can write X and Y as A, X bar plus Y as A bar. Then, according to complementary laws, A plus A bar is equal to 1, A into A bar is equal to 0. According to the complementary laws, what is A? X and Y. X and Y plus A bar. What is A bar? X bar plus Y bar. X bar plus Y bar is equal to 1. And according to second complementary law, A into A bar is equal to 0. What is A? X into Y. A into A bar. X bar plus Y bar is equal to 0. If complement of X and Y, complement of X and Y is X bar plus Y bar, then it must be true that X and Y plus X bar plus Y bar is equal to 1 according to first complementary law. then according to second complementary law, A into A bar is equal to 0. What is A? X and Y. X and Y and A bar, that is X bar plus Y bar. X bar plus Y bar is equal to 0. Let us name it as 1. This first equation, x and y plus x bar plus y bar is equal to 1. Write the LHS. LHS is equal to x into y plus x bar plus y bar. After rearranging this, we get x bar plus y bar plus x into y. Now, we can expand this using second complementary law, that is x plus y into z, that is x plus y into x plus z, x plus y into x plus z. So, we can assume x bar plus y bar as x, x as y, y as z. According to second complementary law, x plus y into z is equal to x plus y into x plus z. What is x? X is assumed as x bar plus y bar. We have assumed x bar plus y bar as x. X plus y. What is y? X. X bar plus y bar plus x into x, that is x bar plus y bar x plus z. X plus z. What is z? That is y. Let us rearrange this. X plus x bar plus y bar into x bar plus y bar. According to first complementary law, x plus x bar is equal to 1, x plus x bar is equal to 1 plus y bar into x bar plus y bar. Y plus y bar is also equal to 1. According to property of 1, 1 plus variable, that is 1 into 1 plus variable 1. According to AND relation, 1 and 1 is equal to 1. Next, second equation, that is x into y into x bar plus y bar is equal to 0. Now, we can expand this equation using De Morgan's first distributive law, that is x into y plus z, x into y plus z. So, x into y plus x into z. So, we can assume x and y as x, x bar as y, y bar as z. Now we can expand it as x and y plus x and z. Okay, what is x? X is x and y and x and y. X bar is y. Y plus x into z. What is x? X is x and y, x dot y and z. Y bar is assumed as z. So, write y bar. Now, x into x bar into y plus x into y bar. According to second complementary law, x into x bar is 0. X into x bar is 0. 0 into y plus x into y into y bar is 0. According to property of 0, 0 into any variable is equal to 0 plus 0 into variable 0. According to our relation, 0 plus 0, 0 plus 0 is 0. That is equal to RHS. That is equal to RHS. So this is De Morgan's second theorem. De Morgan's second theorem states that complement of the product is equal to sum of their individual complements. To prove De Morgan's second theorem using algebraic method, we use complementary laws. Two complementary laws are A plus A bar is equal to 1, A into A bar is equal to 0. If complement of X and Y is X bar plus Y bar, complement of X dot Y is equal to X bar plus Y bar, then we can assume X dot Y as A and X bar plus Y bar as A bar. If complement of X and Y is X bar plus Y bar, then X dot Y is assumed as A, X bar plus Y bar is assumed as A bar. Then according to complementary law, A plus A bar is equal to 1. What is A? X plus Y. That is assumed as A plus A bar. That is X bar plus Y bar is equal to 1. According to second complementary law, A into A bar is equal to 0. What is A? X and Y. And A bar, that is X bar plus Y bar is equal to 0. Here we have written the first equation, that is X into Y plus X bar plus Y bar is equal to 1. Write the LHS. Next, rearrange the terms X bar plus Y bar plus X and Y. Now we can expand this using second distributive law, that is X into Y plus Z. X into Y plus Z, so that we get answer 1. After that we have proved second equation. That is X into Y and X bar plus Y bar. Then we have expanded this using first distributive law, that is X and Y plus Z. Thus we got the answer 0, which is equal to RHS. So this is about De Morgan's theorems. Let us solve some problems using De Morgan's theorems. De Morgan's first theorem is X plus Y whole bar is equal to X bar into Y bar. De Morgan's second theorem is X into Y whole bar is equal to X bar plus Y bar. Solve A into A plus C whole bar using De Morgan's theorems. The given equation is A into A plus C whole bar. A into A plus C whole bar. Now we can expand this using second De Morgan's theorem, that is X into Y. Second De Morgan theorem states that X into Y whole bar is equal to X bar plus Y bar. Now we can assume A as X and A plus C as Y. Now can we expand this using second De Morgan's theorem? Yes, X into Y whole bar, A into A plus C whole bar, that is equal to X bar. What is X? That is A bar plus Y bar. What is Y? A plus C whole bar. Next step, a bar plus, now again we can expand a plus c whole bar using first De Morgan's theorem. First De Morgan's theorem states that x plus y whole bar is equal to x bar into y bar. X bar into y bar. So here a bar into c bar. If we assume a as x, c as y, then according to the theorem a bar into c bar. Okay. Now here in these two terms, a bar is the common term, a bar. So within the bracket there will be 1 in the place of a bar plus c. 1 plus c, we have taken a bar as common term. So within the bracket 1 plus in place of a bar there will be 1 plus a bar is common plus c. A bar, what is 1 plus c according to property of 1, 1 plus variable, 1 plus variable is 1, a bar into 1. Then again according to property of 1, 1 into variable that is equal to variable, that is equal to a bar. Next problem. Problem solve using De Morgan's theorem. Expression is a b bar plus a bar plus a b whole bar. Now we can expand this using De Morgan's first theorem, that is x plus y whole bar is equal to x bar into y bar. By assuming a b bar plus a bar as x, a b as y. Now using De Morgan's first theorem we can expand this, that is x bar and y bar. What is x? A b bar plus a bar is x. X bar, that is a b bar plus a bar bar, and y bar, what is y? A b, y bar is a b bar. Next again we can expand a b bar plus a bar using De Morgan's first theorem. X plus y whole bar is equal to x bar and y bar. By assuming a b bar as x, a bar as y, and we can expand the second term using De Morgan's first theorem, that is x into y whole bar. X into y whole bar, that is equal to x bar plus y bar. By assuming a as x, b as y. Okay, let us expand the a b bar plus a bar using De Morgan's first theorem, that is x bar and y bar. X is a b bar, x bar is a b bar bar plus and y bar, what is y? A bar is y, y bar is a bar bar, and a b whole bar. A b whole bar is equal to a bar plus b bar. A bar plus b bar according to De Morgan's second theorem. Okay, a b bar bar is equal to a b according to involution law. A bar bar is equal to a according to involution law, and a bar plus b bar. Next we can multiply a bar by a b a and b bar by a b a. So in the next step, a b a b a b a plus a b a b bar, sorry, a b a bar plus a b a b bar. A b a b bar, let us rearrange this. A b a bar plus a b b bar. According to second complementary law, variable into complement of that variable is 0. Again here b into b bar is 0. So 0 into any variable is 0. 0 plus 0, that is equal to 0. So here we have solved AB bar plus A bar plus AB whole complement using De Morgan's theorems. So first we have assumed AB bar plus A bar as X, AB as Y. Then we have expanded this using De Morgan's first theorem, that is AB bar plus A bar whole bar X bar, then and AB whole bar. Next AB bar bar and A bar bar and A bar plus B. Then we have multiplied A bar and B bar by AB A. Finally we got the answer 0. Next problem. Find the complement of the expression. F is equal to xy bar plus xz bar plus x bar y. To find out the complement, we need to find out the complement of entire expression. Write the complement of the entire expression, that is x y bar plus x z bar plus x bar y whole complement. Now we can expand this using De Morgan's first theorem by assuming x y bar as plus x z bar as x and x bar y as y. Let us expand this. What is De Morgan's first theorem? X plus y. X plus y whole bar is equal to x bar into y bar. What is x? X y bar plus x z bar. X bar into y bar. That is x bar y whole bar. Now again we can expand this using De Morgan's first theorem by assuming x y bar as x, x z bar as y. And we can expand the second term using De Morgan's second theorem, that is x and y whole bar is equal to x bar plus y bar by assuming x bar as x, y as y. Okay. Next step. X y bar is assumed as x, x z bar is assumed as y. Next step, x bar and y bar. What is x? X y bar is x. So x y bar bar and x z bar bar. And expand this using De Morgan's second theorem, that is x bar bar plus y bar. Again expand this using De Morgan's second theorem, that is x bar plus y bar bar into x bar plus z bar into x bar bar plus y bar. Here we have assumed x as x, y bar as y. Then according to De Morgan's second theorem, x bar plus y bar. Y is y bar means y bar bar. According to involution law, y bar bar is equal to y into x bar plus z bar bar is z into x bar bar is x plus y bar. This is the complement of x bar plus y into x bar plus z, and x plus y bar is the complement of the given expression, that is x y bar plus x z bar plus x bar y. So here we have used demorganization process. Demorganization. Let us see what is demorganization. There are three steps in demorganization. First step is complement the entire function. Complement the entire function. Second step, change all the ands to ors and ors to ands. Third step, complement each of the individual variable. So in the previous problem, we have followed demorganization principle. There are three steps in demorganization. They are complement the entire function, change all the ands to ors, that is dot sign to plus sign, and ors to ands, that is plus sign to dot. Third step, complement each of the individual variables. In the previous example, we have complemented the entire expression. The given expression was x y bar plus x z bar plus x bar y. Complement of the entire function. Here we have complemented the function. Next step, change all the ands to ors and ors to ands. Here and is changed to or, and or is changed to and. Third step, complement each of the individual variable. Here individual variables are complemented. Okay.